Once you have the leg section of your sock to the length that you want it to be, it's time to create the heel flap. We're going to do this on double pointed needles because it gets just a little bit fiddly to try and do everything on the short circular needle. And we're going to create the heel flap on this next set of stitches, so we're going to carry on knitting in the direction that we've been going. And because I've cast on 60 stitches for this sock, then the heel flap will be half of that, so it'll go across 30 stitches. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to tuck this end of the short circular down inside the sock so that it doesn't flap about and get in my way. And I'm going to knit the first stitch of this first row. And the reason for that is otherwise if we slip it, we end up getting a hole just around there. So I'm going to knit the first stitch and knit the second stitch. And then after that, I'm going to do slip one, knit one all the way across. Now I'm going to slip one purlwise and then knit one. Slip one purlwise and then knit one, and I'm going to do that all the way across. Now people do ask whether it really matters whether you slip knitwise or purlwise, and I think that with a sock heel it's personal preference. Generally if you slip knitwise, it means that when you come to do the purl row then the stitches are all lying in the same direction. If you slip knitwise, then you'll find that the stitch is twisted, so you can either just turn the stitch around or you could knit it twisted, which gives you a slightly twisted rib heel flap, which isn't unattractive. It's just that you'd need to be aware that that's what was going to happen. So I'm going to continue the slip one knit one all the way along until I get to 30 stitches. What I'm going to do now is tuck this end of the needle down inside the sock, so both ends of my short circular are tucked away down there out of the way. I'm now going to turn my sock around and I'm going to work my way back along the heel flap. So I'm going to slip the first stitch and then I'm going to purl every stitch back along the row. So having done row two, so that's the purl row that brings us back to the start of our heel flap again, we've turned our sock round and we're ready to do row three. Now we're not going to knit this first stitch, we're going to slip it purlwise. And these slip stitches on either end are what's going to make it easy for you to pick up the gusset stitches later on. So we're going to slip the first stitch purlwise, knit the second stitch, and then it's exactly the same as for the first row that you did. So you're going to slip one, knit one, slip one, knit one, all the way along the row. Here we are back at the end of the row again. I've turned my sock and I'm ready to go back to row two, so that's the purl row. I'm going to slip one purlwise and then I'm going to purl all the way back along this row. And you just repeat row two and row three all the way along your heel flap until you get it to the length that you want it to be. And it needs to be about 2 inches, maybe 2.5 inches. It just depends on the height of your own heel, and you can measure that for yourself by measuring up from the ground to where your heel finishes.